Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make a glow effect in Meduang Paint. So firstly, you're going to want to have something that you want to make glow. For this example, I'm just going to be using a circle. So first, I'm going to be adding a darker background so that we can see the glow better. Then, on a separate layer, I'm going to make the thing that we want to glow. So I'm having lighter line art here just so that you can see it better, but you can have any color line art that you want, even black or white, depending on like the background. You can also fill your thing in with color, which is what I'm going to be doing here. It is not a particularly bright color because we want the glow to stand out. Also bear in mind this is not going to look perfect because we are aiming for a tutorial and not for perfection. And don't be upset if you can't get it perfect the first time, too. Next, we're going to make one layer below it and one layer above it. The one below will be used for glow from behind, and the one above will just be used for the general glow that it's giving off. You're going to want to set them both to the add function. This one makes things glow. I personally like to make sure that the add layers aren't on full opacity, and this can take a good few layers to get right as well. I think it's always good to go the more saturated color, and you will see right here that it makes it a bit glowy. This is the layer underneath, by the way, which is why it's not going over the middle part. Then you can Gaussian blur or blur by yourself with a tool, but I'm going to be using the Gaussian function here just because it is quicker and easier to show. And you can turn the brightness, you can turn the opacity up or down, but I personally like to keep it kind of down. And then layer it with another one right above that. It can be whatever opacity you want, but I think it's good to do this. Then you're gonna have this sort of thing and blur it again at whatever level of blurring you want it to be. I like it to be quite high so that it blends in nicely. And then for me personally, even though we're still on the behind section, I like to add a little bit of really bright white. White always tends to emphasize a glow or light, so just having a little bit of white right there, again, not perfect, will really, really help the effect. So just blur it however you would like. Make sure that it isn't too blurred, because otherwise it won't look too glowy. And then set it. You can mess with the opacity if you want again, but I think having it fairly high is good. So I personally would keep it from anywhere from the 30s to the 90s. Depending on how strong you want your glow to be. Now for the upper parts. So you're going to want to make a layer above the object that you want to glow. And then set it on add again. You're going to get another blue or whatever color that you want it to be the glow color of. So if you want the color of the glow to be yellow, then make it yellow. And just set that around the top. But leave some of the middle part empty so that you can still see the original color. Then you're going to want to blur that again until you see it blends in nicely. Then, if you want, you can add some more, which I personally will be doing because I really enjoy messing around with glowy features. They're my absolute favorite thing to do. You can keep doing that part as much as you would like. I personally am just going to add a little bit more on a low opacity and then blur it out once more. Bear in mind, this is just how I do things, and you can do things in a completely different way that you want to do them. But as you can see, this makes a very glowy effect. Again, you can change the opacities on any of the layers you want. If you want it to be outward and a much bigger glow, then you can always just make another layer and make it go out a lot. Remember to leave some of the original color in the center just so that it's not lost. For me personally, if you want to make a really outwards faint glow, then just do it out with very low opacity and blur it out a ton. You can keep adding on to that if you want. On very low opacities again, just to get that effect, which I personally really like to do. I am not a professional at all, but this is just how I do things, and they tend to look okay most of the time. So, that is how to make a glow effect in Medibang Paint. You're probably going to need a lot of layers for this if you want to do it as I did. The way we did it took about 10 layers, so it might clog it up a bit, so I would recommend putting these in a layer folder. Thank you very much for watching. If you want more specific tutorials, do comment. I hope you enjoy, and I will see you all soon. Bye!